Hey there! Have you ever experienced a teamfight where you had no clue about what is happening? Teammates throw themselves into the enemy one by one? Is there hardly a single engage that you can win? We are going to show you how team dynamics can win you games. Stay with us! Hello guys, welcome to the dojo. Let's cut to the chase. What is an engagement? An engagement is a teamfight where both teams are facing each other at their full potential. Teams usually want to group up and attack together to have the highest chance to take the objective. We are going to dissect the dynamics and show you what is happening. Pay attention, as a good engagement is made of a lot of tiny variables. Alright, this guide is dependent on our video about good communication. If you really want to make good engages happen, you need to be able to talk to and talk with your teammate. By understanding the concepts we are going to draft up, you will have an easy time coordinating your team. Click on the card to watch that video right now. So let's talk about what leads to an engagement. Before they begin, the attackers must evaluate the enemy forces. First of all, check their team composition and decide if you have a solid counter to their team. If not, are you safe to ignore this fact? In most cases, you want to be on the safe side, except when you are doing some cheesy thing yourself. You should always prepare for possible threats in the enemy team, like a Hanzo who can pick you before you get in position and draw shields, or a Mei who can cut you in half, etc, etc. The next thing to check is their team position compared to yours. Who has the advantage of the high ground, covers and chokes? Are you safe to engage? If so, how? If you are not safe to attack them directly, what route can you take? For example, if the enemy team takes the high ground on Hollywood defense, you can either try to fight them there or just go to the right side behind shields and force them to come to you. Then you need to consider target priority. Try to decide who to eliminate first in order to maximize your chances of winning the fight. For example, a Mercy with ult should always be your first target, as she can just res anyone you killed with a single ultimate. So what are the main threats to a successful engagement? Discuss a priority list of targets before the engagement. It's important to stick to the same targets and kill them more quickly than they kill your team. The next one is, how can you deal with their setup? Decide what is going to be the most effective way to counter the enemy team. Which routes are the best to take or guard? Positional advantage can win you games, and you can split the enemy team with a good engage, making it hard for them to focus you. The next one is, do they have ultimates? If yes, which ones? Can they do a wombo combo? And the last is, do you have ultimates? And if yes, which ones? Can you do a wombo combo? Once the required data has been gathered, it's time to establish a plan of action. Let's see a hands-on example on Numbani attack. Alright, the opponent's team composition is the following. They have Reinhardt and Zarya for the tanks, Soldier and McCree for the DPS, and Ana, Zenyatta for the support. And your team composition is a tank-heavy dive comp. The tanks are Winston, Roadhog and Zarya, the single DPS is Genji, the supports are Ana and Lucio. Let's say the first engagement is happening. After a few seconds, your in-game leader decides that your team can take on theirs as is. He positions Genji and Winston on main to dive on Soldier and Ana, focusing Ana first. The rest of the team will break the choke and face the other team head on. This is an example engagement, but you should get the idea. Before we continue, we would like to invite you to our Discord server, where a lot of players from all over the world are helping each other on a daily basis. Join us and let's improve together. First of all, a good team always has someone who coordinates their movements. This person is usually present in competitive games, and you can see someone taking the lead in solo queue too. We are calling this role the in-game leader. So, let's get back to our example. Your in-game leader gives the signal to go, Winston and Genji jump on Soldier and Ana. Meanwhile, Roadhog and Zarya start to work on the Reinhardt shield. The situation plays out like this. Winston and Genji die from the crossfire of their DPS. Your Hog dies to Zarya before he could flee. Zarya, Lucio and Ana back off thanks to the speed boost with a sliver of health. So, this thing failed clearly, but how can we make it work? An engagement is a fluid setup. What to do can change from seconds to seconds depending on the opponent's response to your engagement. Engaging first forces the opponent to react to your push, and it puts your team in a favorable position. This is the advantage of the initiative. If they don't have a strategy or tactic in place for this specific engagement, they will lose some players. Thus, the best way to engage is to engage quickly and decisively. Follow through the priority list as fast as you can and give your opponent less time to react and adjust. Never second guess during the actual engagement, as this will cause delay and therefore a lost engagement. Following a bad decision together as a team is better than everyone doing what they think is best. In our previous example, a good decision would have been to commit the whole team to just one side or to switch roles before the first engagement. You know that their weak point is the isolated duo, Soldier and Anna. They do not have speed boost to move their team in response to your engagement out of harm's way. One solution could be to switch the Winston to D.Va, because Soldier and Anna moves away from the diving tank and then focus the Soldier with Genji while D.Va uses her defense matrix to protect the diving duo from McCree, Soldier and Anna while your Anna support the duo from the low ground. Hog could be switched to a sniper to force their shield in a certain position to get a pick on the second support or McCree if they turn the shield away. Yes, well, switching takes time, but jumping into really bad engages takes a lot more, plus you are giving ultimate charge to the enemy. If you see the situation is really not in your favor, for example someone gets picked really quickly and then you would just wither away, just fall back and swap. Speaking about falling back, let's discuss when and how to disengage properly. Disengaging is one of the most complicated things to determine in a push. To recognize when an engagement failed can be an arduous task. It relies heavily on your in-game leader to identify the situation and give the correct call. From our previous example, the main disengage occurred when Genji and Winston died. This is the time when Lucio should have used the amped up speed to get out of the situation before losing the Roadhog and giving away free ultimate charge to the enemy team. Recognizing when to disengage can be really hard, and this skill is mostly honed by experience. You can always watch how pro players do this, analyzing their games when the tides of battle turns against them. They are rarely wiped, always managing to get away with some players. So here come some examples when disengaging is heavily recommended. You are more than one teammate down and you can't make it an equal fight. Or losing a big tactical advantage like your Reinhardt at the start of a push or a main healer. Or your team composition is heavily countered by theirs. Or several of your teammates are affected by statuses like heal ban or hack. In this situation, it's best to disengage until there's a cleanse ability in the game besides Zarya's bubble. The next is, they are using an ultimate like Blizzard or Tactical Visor. Just backpedal, hide and wait until it is over. The last one is, you have several low health teammates and the enemy team is less damage and abilities are not immediately ready. Just disengage, wait for them to heal up and go in again. So, applying this knowledge is a lot easier with a premade team, we know that. But what can you do when you are playing in solo? Overwatch is a team game and you need to play with 5 strangers in your ranked matches. If you are willing to climb, you need to use all the tools there are to achieve victory. By understanding the dynamics of Overwatch, you are going to be able to help your team moving and acting together. On lower levels, your best bet is to use the in-game chat or voice to prepare for engagements. People can be hard to deal with, but everyone wants to win, even Hanzo mains. By giving them directions and the path of engagement, you can help the team win fights. On higher levels, this knowledge is supposed to be common. However, drafting up a plan for engagement will still help you a lot in your team fights, so don't be shy to do it. Okay, if you want to improve this knowledge besides the basics, you want to understand how to react to any situation. And the best thing to do is to play matches, record them and analyze the team engagements. You need to consider if you had every piece of information you needed before the team engaged. See if the targets go down in priority order, if any positional mistakes were made or someone not followed your directions. By analyzing these engages step by step from your perspective, you can understand how a certain engage can go wrong. And you are going to be able to react to this situation in your future games. You can also analyze pro matches if you feel like. Thank you for taking your time to improve. Start practicing good engagements and your rank and your team skill will get better. If you like this video, subscribe, give us a thumbs up and share it now. Your friends may need this knowledge too. Support us on Patreon so we can keep producing high quality Overwatch guides. See you guys next time.